You know, I'm the old guy invading, the old undercover cop invading the high school comedy team.
Hey, youngsters. Hey, youngsters, how are you doing? Dude, I already had that, like, that fear in my heart, in my head, like, ooh, there's so many, like, foreigners and, like, shady under air quotes, shady people. Like, there has to be at least one undercover cop, and it's not me. So it can only be the other Austrian white dude that is not disabled.
Yeah, Nicolette, I'm watching him also. He's it's probably him.
Don't challenge my diehard knowledge. I'm not a diehard fan.
That, like, that shit was made in the late 80s or when? Diehard fan.
Dude, the boobs are on fleek. Like...
So I don't know what that means, but there were some in the movie.
I'm gonna dab on those boobs. Like, no, the tits were amazing in this one.
Also, maybe I'd mention that a couple of spaces below where Arnold Schwarzenegger is.
Yeah, exactly. Like, it's Demon Rituals, boobs, Arnold Schwarzenegger. It's not gonna be Red
exactly,
Heat. And
like
it's
that.
Not gonna be
twins.
It's not twins. It's not gonna be twins. No. No, we are not.
It's
one
a sort of a
kind.
Darker theme.
Yeah.
It starts off. It reminds me
it's
a little bit
twins,
of coffee in the blender. Puts a slice of pizza in the blender.
Yeah. All the best ingredients.
Something else in.
Yeah.
And
that seemed
like
a
wow.
very healthy Jamie Oliver kind of recipe that he tried and there. Yeah, it is protein shake. You know.
Yeah. I felt bad for Arnold.
Oh, he had actually had a one-liner about it, like.
Yeah, you gotta
breakfast is the most important meal of the day.
That was for sure in reference to his private life, I guess. That's one of the best parts of Pumping Iron. There's a scene where there's like 20 bodybuilders around the table and they're all ordering food. And the first guy does like an order and the second guy's like, I'll have that and this on top. And then
the next one is like, and on that. They all have to one up each other. Yeah. I can put my mask on the new. Get to the chopper.
Yeah,
right? Why didn't he say that?
He could have said it.
No callback there. It's pre-ironic Arnold. It's before he realized that his whole persona is a joke to the Americans. It's like he still was like, I'm serious about this movie. And the director's like, yeah, Arnold, sure. You're serious about this movie. Now say this line, please. Okay, I'm gonna shredder this voice. No wonder nobody follows his commands because they can't understand him. Get him.
Yeah,
what did he say?
I don't know. I wrote this down. In the when they're rolling the credits, they have his dialect coach and his name is Walter von Hüne.
1999. You've been in the United States for what 30 plus years?
No, also it's such a cliche German sounding name. I'm like, no, you didn't get the point of dialect coach. You need to get the dialect coach who speaks the language you want to learn.
Get
a dialect John Smith, Michael Miller.
No, Ciao, Bing, Bung, your new dialect coach.
In Polish.
Yeah, in Polish, Kurwa. Excellent. Obviously in disbelief because, again, he got his fucking tongue cut out. Not cut out. He cut it
The priest
out
had
himself.
It already cut out, yeah.
Yeah, he himself cut it out.
Cut it out.
Cut it out. Come on, guys. Don't. How do you do cunnilingus without a tongue? It's just lips. Nobody loves that.
No more tongue-in-cheek comments for him.
Apparently you can if you're Arnold Schwarzenegger.
If you are Arnold Schwarzenegger,
no,
rated
seriously,
Arnold.
It's apparently...
It's rated R for Arnold.
Sedate him.
It was the fucking fin de siècle. It was 1999. You're like, God damn it. Every plot, every screenplay, every plot
let's
idea.
Let's recycle it. Yeah.
That has something to do. We can only make these movies once, people.
Yeah, that would be funny. Like the director actually thought the world would end. And he's like, I can plagiarize everybody because we're going to be all dead afterwards. It's not going to matter. Who's going to sue me if anybody's dead? Yeah.
And yes. Luckily, the book has lots of pictures because he's not fucking reading the text. He grabbed a medallion from one of the priests, and it's a sword hidden in the heart.
Yes.
And he waves through the pages book. Of the book. And all of a sudden, there's a picture
it's pre-Google.
Of exactly that medallion in the book. And he's like, oh, my God, these things go together.
Yeah, he's putting one and one together, literally, yeah.
I mean that in the nicest way possible, Arnold. So really.
Arnold, if you're listening to this, come on, it's only in love and respect to you that I'm doing this voice.
Of course.
Come on.
See, he's doing it. I'm not even doing it. I can't.
I love you, man. Come on my podcast. Come on, Arnold. It's very important to me. We can do Pumping Iron together. I can pump your iron.
The
Jesus metaphors don't really shine through in this one.
Because that's the subtext.
They're very subtle. They're very subtle Arnold about the Jesus metaphors. Yeah, yeah. He doesn't sacrifice himself.
He turned water
himself.
To muscles.
Muscle milk. Yeah.
And then the badass priest that comes Lord, in.
Actually, that is a thing. They're called
muscles for Jesus.
Something like that. Yeah, like they're bodybuilders.
And they hold muscle mass.
probably. And the body of Christ is probably just a protein bar or something like that.
The body of Christ.
Yeah, yeah. The body of Christ get shredded for God.
Yeah. Like his plan was to have sex with that lady through Arnold's body.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That was the whole
thing. Oh, so make it like a super strong.
Yes, exactly.
Antichrist.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Oh, Arnold would have been the one. But it doesn't come to that. Because then Arnold is struggling with himself. And here again, some of Arnold's best work. He's
muscles you can believe in.
He's acting against himself.
Yeah.
And it really looks like a struggle. So that's why I can say that.
He's struggling with himself. It's pretty funny. Yeah. And then he tosses himself on Gabriel's sword.
Yeah. The sword that... Is there like now the fifth time it's in a shot? And
yeah. No,
the first
that was,
one we were like, all right, pretty much someone's gonna fall on that sword or it's gonna be used.
Yeah, exactly. It's gonna. It was a Chekhov's sword, and he tosses himself on that sword.
Nobody jacked off with the sword. No. I don't know what you were watching, but I get your reference.
Yeah,
get
cuts all over my hands. Arnold
Chekhov gun, that's the term, no?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, that's now so much funnier.
Thanks.
That's how I call my penis. The Chekhov gun.
If you show it in the first act, it has to be used by the third act.
Yeah. So, people
that's
don't
the
like,
rule of theater.
People don't like going to the theater with me. Blind black albino. Yeah. I guess, can I say
blue
that?
Albino?
Well.
Blaubano dude, yeah. Sure.
You think there's a name for that condition?
Yeah, it's called what's it called? It has its own name. Extreme Michael Jackson syndrome. Yes.
Like that was his idea. Yeah. I have an idea for this effect.
Yeah. Let's make it invisible. Come on, guys. You know what fears man the most? The thing that he can't see. It's very deep. Come on, guys. It taps into the inner part of your soul.
Yeah. Not
the foot soul, the soul in your heart.
It taps into the inner part of your soul, rips out femur.
Yes, yes. Yeah, it's gonna break your goddamn spine.
But what was an interesting CGI was when they were having that gruesome gruesome threesome.
Great, first of all, excellent play of words, I love it. Fuck you, Jack and Reggie. That's how somebody is a team player right there.
I don't know what I did.
The pussy in the fridge was pretty good.
Oh, the cat, you mean? Yes.
Yeah, yes, pussy. There was no literal who keeps pussies in the freezer? I mean, in the summertime, I guess, if you
the
just want something
seven.
Cold around in around
around your beer.
Yeah. Uzi, yeah. You shop a can. Jeffrey Dahmer just keeps his like the police force is like, why did you keep like 12 vagina lifts in your freezer? Oh, if I have friends over and like we watch the ball game, we watch the games, we want.
You can have that joke. It's all yours.
That's gross and not funny.
You don't know me. I'm a, compared to you, I'm a fucking choir boy.
Right? 99?
No, no. Titanic was, I'm going to say.
98?
69.
69?
Yeah.
No, wait. It can't
Titanic,
be.
Leonardo DiCaprio.
Yeah, Leonardo DiCaprio.
69. I'm going to double down. 69.
It's so not true on so many levels. He wasn't even alive in 69.
96.
69. I was like, is he trying 96. To make a really bad Kate Winslet and him doing 69 on those plank of wood jokes? But no, like that.
69 me like one of your French girls.
Yeah.